सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ हुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माण विजाति पूर्वं वेदांश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुरोऽयि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायान्तिक संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। क्लोज दी विंडो एनीवे। ओके, यथा पूर्वं ब्रह्मविद्या प्रमात्वात् शुक्तिज्ञानस्यैव स्वफले कर्म अनपेक्ष इत्यभाणि तथा। सो वी हैड सीन दिस संगति। पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट द वे ब्रह्मविद्या इज प्रमा एंड डज नॉट एक्सपेक्ट कर्म, एनी कर्म, मीनिंग कर्म इज नॉट सब्सिडरी टू ब्रह्मज्ञान प्रमात्वात् हेतोः। Like what? Like Shukti Jnana. Shukti Jnana does not expect any karma as subsidiary. And Shukti Jnana itself gives the phala, swaphala, which is what? Avidya Nivritti. And thereby Shukti Avidya Nivrittau Sati. Once Shukti Ajnana goes away, then the Rajata Brahma also goes away. And Shukti appears as Shukti. Similarly, Brahmavidya Phala is Swatantra. There is no karma needed once Brahmavidya takes away Brahma Atma Avidya, Aikya Avidya, and then nothing else is needed. So, karma anepeksha iti abhani. This was established by the Siddhanti. Now, Purvapakshi says, Tatha sotpattau api karma anepeksha pramatvadeva iti astu. इति दृष्टांत संगत्या इदमाह। सो सोत्पत्तो मीनिंग टुवर्ड्स इट्स ओन राइज, फॉर द राइज ऑफ ब्रह्म विद्या इज देयर एक्सपेक्टेंसी ऑफ कर्मा और नॉट। ही पूर्व पक्षी सेज देयर इज नो एक्सपेक्टेंसी। नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी ट्रिकी संगति। व्हाई इट इज ट्रिकी इज बिकॉज कर्मकांडी सेइंग दैट कर्म अपेक्षा मेट नॉट बी देयर इज वेरी क्यूरियस एंड इट इज ट्रिकी। इट्स अ ट्रैप। It's a trap in the sense we'll see how it is a trap, in the sense that if you agree to it, what will be the result is that finally he'll say that if karma is not needed, then it is vidyastuti. And then he'll say that, which means that Brahmajnana won't take place via karma, nitya karma, via chitta shuddhi, and thereby being stuti, there is nothing called as moksha via Brahmajnana. This is his hidden agenda really, which will be clear. Otherwise, see, or otherwise the sutra itself will not go together with the sangati, especially one that is going to come up in the series of these sutras. So we'll see how it is a little tricky here. So Siddhanti says sarvapeksha adhikaranam, in the sarvapeksha adhikaranam Siddhanti gives the sutra sarvapeksha cha yajnyadi shrute rashvat, sarvapeksha cha yajnyadi shrute rashvat, sarvapeksha. Sarvapeksha means सर्वेषां आश्रमकर्मणां अपेक्षा, वॉट एवर इज दी विहित कर्म इन वन्स ओन वर्णाश्रम अपेक्षा, एक्सपेक्टेंसी ऑफ दैट इज डेफिनेटली देयर। फॉर वॉट? फॉर द राइज ऑफ ब्रह्म विद्या। if the Agnihotra by the Grahastha is done for Swarga Prapti as a Kamya Karma, then it will not give Chitta Shuddhi. Then it will not be the cause for rise of Brahma Vidya. But if it is done for Chitta Shuddhi as Nitya Karma because it is Vihita, not because I want something else, then it will lead to Chitta Shuddhi, and Chitta Shuddhi Dwara it will be means to the rise of Brahma Jnana, Brahma Vidya. This is the position of the Sutrakara Siddhanti. Yajnadi Shrutehe Ashwavata. How? Yajnadi Shrutehe. So, why is it so? Why is there Sarva Karma Apeksha, Vihita Karma Apeksha for Brahma Jnana? Because Yajnadi Shruti is there. We'll see this Yajnadi Shruti, not Yavad Jiva Shruti. Yavad Jiva Shruti will be quoted by the Purvapakshi later. But Yajnadi Shruti is whereby Yajnena Danena Tapasa Vividishanti. That is the Yajnadi Shruti. We'll see the quotation later. But Yajnadi Shruti means the Upanishad Shruti, which says that Yajna Ityadi become the cause for Vividisha, Veditum Icha. So Vividisha Sannyasa or Brahma Vettumicha, that will be there only if karma, vihita karma is done as nitya karma without any expectancy of result. This is what the Upanishad says. So that Yajnadi Shruti is Hetu for Sarvapeksha, meaning Ashrama Vihita Karma Apeksha for Brahma Jnana Utpatti, Brahma Vidya Utpatti. This Ashwavat is the answer to the tricky, curious approach that the Purvapakshi has taken. This Ashwavat will see as to how the horse, Ashwa horse, is useful for a particular karma and not for another karma. So how horse is useful. But just because horse is useful, it does not mean that horse can be used for anything and everything. Meaning, the Purvapakshi is saying that let the karma not be useful for rise of Brahma Jnana, just like it is not useful for rise of Moksha. Brahma Jnana itself, independently, Swatantrena, is sufficient to give Swaphala, which is Moksha. But for Sotpatti, it needs Swashrama Vihita Karma. This is the Siddhanta. However, Purvapakshi, by saying that let the Brahma Vidya for its utpatti, for its own utpatti, not have dependency on any karma, just like it has no dependency. The Brahma Vidya does not have any dependency on karma for rise of its phala, which is moksha. Now, if you agree to that, he is going to say that since there is no expectancy of karma, which he knows you won't agree. So he is going to say then it is a stuti. Why? Because it should be practiced not only by a mumukshu but by amumukshu api. I am making a setup for the coming up sutras also so that we can go slightly faster. Because this sarvapeksha adhikarana is sowing the seed for returning to what Purvapakshi has in his mind. Meaning for moksha also karma is needed. How will he land there? He thinks that once you get into this trap of agreeing that karma is not needed for Brahma Jnana, Utpatti of Brahma Jnana, then it will be like discarding the Karma Kanda, so you will become Nastika. That is not going to be possible. So you will agree, Siddhanti will agree that karma is needed. Then he is going to ask whether this karma is to be done, Nitya Karma, for Chitta Shuddhi, or it should be done by Amumukshu also. One who wants moksha, moksha ichchu mumukshu, by him alone it should be done, Nitya Karma, or it should be done by one who is not interested in moksha, that kind of a brahmachari grahastha also, Amumukshu. So he is going to bring that kind of a setup, and if you say that it is to be done by both, then the, being Nitya Karma, it has to be done from done by both types of meaning sadhaka and non-sadhaka, mumukshu and non-mumukshu, then it is a stuti for Brahma Vidya Utpatti Karma, Nitya Karma is a cause. It's a stuti, he'll say. And therefore, there is nothing called as Brahma Vidya Utpatti due to this, since Nitya Karma has to be done by both mumukshu and non-mumukshu, amumukshu. Thereby, it is only stuti. There is nothing called as independent phala of Brahma Vidya also, because Brahma Vidya will not come up as a result of Nitya Karma, because Nitya Karma is there for Amumukshu also. Amumukshu will remain Amumukshu. So how will Mumukshu become qualified for Moksha? This is the approach he is going to take, and then he will say that because this is the Mimamsa, therefore Karma alone will give moksha also, since it has to be done by everyone, whether a mumukshu or a non-mumukshu, which is agreeable to Siddhanti also. Therefore, that itself will lead to moksha. So he is trying to reset everything that the Siddhanti has established right from the first adhikarana of this fourth pada of the third adhyaya. So with this in mind, let's go through sarvapeksha cha yajnyadi shrute ashwavat. To this, the Siddhanti is going to say Ashwavat. What Ashwavat means, we'll see in the Vritti. Atra Purva Pakshe Jnanartham Yajnyadyanushthana Abhavaha Siddhante Tadanushthana Avashyam Bhava Iti Phalabheda. So this Sangati that is being given from the Purva Pakshi's perspective is not what really is in his mind. What really is in his mind will be seen in the Vritti, which is countered by Ashwavat. Therefore, this sutra is a little tricky. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे ज्ञानार्थम यज्ञादि अनुष्ठान अभाव यज्ञ इत्यादि विहित कर्म अनुष्ठान इज नॉट नीडेड फॉर ज्ञान ब्रह्म ज्ञान इट विल नॉट लीड टू ब्रह्म ज्ञान उत्पत्ति सेज दि पूर्वपक्षी सिद्धांते तद अनुष्ठान अवश्यम भाव इति फलभेद सिद्धांती सेज दैट इन सिद्धांत वेदांत सिद्धांत डेफिनेटली विहित कर्म वर्णाश्रम कर्म धर्म शुड बी फॉलोड अवश्यम भाव अवश्यत्वेन अदरवाइज ब्रह्मज्ञान वोंट टेक प्लेस इट इज चित्त शुद्धि कारक एंड परंपराया इट विल लीड टू मोक्ष आल्सो अत्र किम विद्याया सोत्पत्तौ कर्म अपेक्षा अस्ति न वा इति संदेह नास्ति इति पूर्वपक्ष वेदर टुवर्ड्स द राइज ऑफ इटसेल्फ ब्रह्म विद्या हैज एक्सपेक्टेंसी ऑफ कर्म और नॉट इफ दिस डाउट इज देयर नास्ति पूर्वपक्षी सेज नो देयर इज नो डिपेंडेंसी ऑफ कर्म for rise of Brahma Jnana. Now this is a Purva Pakshi or a different Purva Pakshi who has made the akshepa that karma is needed for moksha. Now he is saying that Brahma Jnana which leads to moksha, for that Brahma Jnana karma is not needed. So very funny. In the first step you don't need it, in the second step you need it. So you can consider it to be a different Purva Pakshi, but it is not the different Purva Pakshi. It is a hidden agenda which is going to come up. सिद्धांतस्तु विद्यायाः स्वोत्पत्तौ सर्वेषाम् आश्रमकर्मणाम् अपेक्षा अस्ति सो सर्वापेक्षा इज षष्ठी तत्पुरुष सर्वेषाम् अपेक्षा अस्ति सर्वेषाम् केषाम् आश्रमकर्मणाम् विहित कर्मणाम् नित्यकर्मणाम् अपेक्षा अस्ति फॉर व्हाट विद्यायाः स्वोत्पत्तौ विद्या हैज एक्सपेक्टेंसी ऑफ वर्णाश्रम धर्म फॉर इट्स राइज कुतः वाई सो यज्ञादिश्रुतेः सेज दि सिद्धांति वड़े यज्ञादि श्रुति विविदिशन्ति यज्ञेन दानेन तपसा इत्यादि श्रुति इज देयर यज्ञेन दानेन सो यज्ञ दान तपस इत्यादि आर आश्रम विहित कर्म सम आर दान इत्यादि आर कॉमन फॉर ऑल यज्ञ यज्ञ इज कॉमन फॉर सम दोज आर यज्ञोपवीत सो विविदिशन्ति वेदितुमिच्छन्ति दिस इज हाउ ज्ञानेन मोक्षा इज पॉसिबल बट दैट ज्ञान इट्सेल्फ इज पॉसिबल ओनली आफ्टर चित्तशुद्धि वाया यज्ञ एंड दान यज्ञ दान एट्सेट्रा इत्यादिना इत्यादि तपस इत्यादि इज देयर यज्ञादि कर्मणाम इत्यादिना यज्ञादि कर्मणाम विविदिशा द्वारा ज्ञान साधनत्व श्रवणात् सो इट इज अ ज्ञान साधना व्हाट इज ज्ञान साधना ब्रह्म विद्या साधना यज्ञादि कर्म, यज्ञ दान तपस। हाउ? परंपराया विविदिशा द्वारा वेदितुम इच्छा शुड बी देर, दैट इच्छा विल बी बॉर्न ओनली वेन द माइंड इज नॉट क्लाउडेड, वेन विवेक ऑफ नित्य अनित्य सद असत ऑल दिस टेक्स प्लेस, एंड देर बाय वेन चित्त शुद्धि इज देर देन अलोन दिस इच्छा विल कम अप। मोक्षे इच्छा दैट टू ब्रह्म ज्ञाने इच्छा, दैट क्लैरिटी ऑल्सो विल कम अप ओनली वेन देर इज चित्त शुद्धि, and that chitta shuddhi is possible only via ashrama vihita karma. And this ashrama vihita karma is important because each ashrama has slightly different need. For nitya karma to lead to chitta shuddhi, it should be one's own ashrama vihita karma, not somebody else's ashrama vihita karma. It cannot be ashrama avihita karma also. Although in today's era, since ashrama vihita karma is being followed very minimally, if at all, therefore other karma is also taken into account, but these can be smartha karma, not secular karma. Secular karma, one can say, okay, any karma that I do, as Krishna said, offer it to me, offer it to him, Bhagwan. So in that sense, it can be seen, but it is not going to be साक्षात चित्त शुद्धि कारक इन शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. सो साक्षात मीनिंग इट विल लीड टू चित्त शुद्धि, बट इट विल टेक अ लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन देन व्हाट इज द विहित कर्म. व्हाई? बिकॉज वन हैज टेकन जन्म इन अ पर्टिकुलर वर्णाश्रम, वर्ण एंड फॉलोइंग अ पर्टिकुलर आश्रम, वेदर गृहस्थ और ब्रह्मचारी, वेदर वन बिकम्स अ गृहस्थ due to one's own purva samskara, or one remains brahmachari due to one's own samskara or prarabdha. Therefore, whatever is the karma for that particular varnashrama that one finds oneself in at any point of time, that alone will give chitta shuddhi. Karma vihita in that particular ashrama and varna alone will give चित्त शुद्धि फास्टर. परधर्मो भयावहः सेड भगवान कृष्ण इन गीता, गीताचार्य टू अर्जुन, वी शुड नॉट फॉलो समबडी एल्सेस धर्म, इट इज नॉट स्वधर्म. सो इवन इफ वी कैन डू लिटिल ऑफ अवर ओन स्वधर्म, इट इज मच बेटर देन डूइंग समथिंग एल्स. मरणमपि श्रेयः सेड भगवान कृष्ण गीताचार्य टू अर्जुन, कंपेयर टू डूइंग परधर्म आचरण. And this will come up in the context of the sutras that are following. So thereby vividishadvara yajnadi karma become jnana sadhana. This is seen in the shruti itself. So shravanat nanu paramparaya jnanotpattu karma apeksha avat mokshe api astu apeksha. So Purvapakshi is making akshepa nanu paramparaya jnanotpattu karma apeksha avat. This is his hidden agenda. He says if it is परंपराया साधना यज्ञादि कर्म फॉर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति, सो कर्म अपेक्षा इज देर, देन सिमिलरली कर्म अपेक्षावत लेट देर बी परंपराया ज्ञानोत्पत्तो साधनत्वम कर्मापेक्षा फॉर मोक्ष ऑल्सो, मोक्षे अपि अस्तु अपेक्षा फॉर मोक्ष ऑल्सो लेट देर बी आश्रमहित कर्म. सो हैविंग सेड दैट karma is not needed for brahma vidya utpatti, now he is saying that if it is needed for brahma vidya utpatti, let it be needed for moksha also, thereby karmana moksha. This is what he wants to establish. So this is the hidden agenda. To that Siddhanti answers, no, tatra aha ashwavat. So what is this ashwavat? So the sutrakara has read the mind of the Purvapakshi. What is hidden agenda is, because if this कर्मकांडी इज सेइंग दैट लेट देयर नॉट बी नीड फॉर कर्म, लेट देयर नॉट बी नीड ऑफ कर्म फॉर उत्पत्ति ऑफ ब्रह्मज्ञान, हू हैज बीन इंसिस्टिंग कर्म विल लीड टू मोक्ष, ही हैज कम बैक एंड सेड दैट कर्म इज नीडेड फॉर मोक्ष. देयर फॉर अश्ववत सेड द वेदांती सिद्धांती, यथा अश्व योग्यता बलात् रथचर्यायां विनियुज्यते न लांगलकर्षणे तद्वत् कर्मणां मोक्षे योग्यत्वा भावात् न अपेक्षा इत्यर्थः. सो सिद्धांति सेज अश्ववत लाइक अ हॉर्स इज नीडेड ओनली फॉर व्हाट यथा अश्व योग्यता बलात्. वेर इज द योग्यता ऑफ अश्व? जस्ट बिकॉज अश्व कैन बी जॉइंड विथ रथ टू मूव द रथ चैरियट, सो द हॉर्स कैन बी टाइड टू द चैरियट एंड बाय रनिंग और वॉकिंग द हॉर्स कैन पुल द चैरियट. देयर फोर योग्यता बला इज देयर फॉर अश्व टू पुल द रथ चैरियट. Just because it can pull the chariot with a lot of load also, does it mean that the horse can be vinyujyate, can be connected to the chariot? Similarly, can it be connected to langala karshana for the purpose of karshana using a langala? Langala is a plow. So, for what? In a farmer's field, can it be used for farming? If the horse is used for farming, horse will not be limited to your own farm and entire day you keep on doing, you will be running after the horse. So just because it can pull a chariot does not mean that it can be used to pull the plow. Of course it is samartha to pull the plow, but it is not yogya there. Just because it can pull does not mean it should be used. So Siddhanti is making a pun there. He says that similarly karma, although karma is yogya to give चित्त शुद्धि एंड चित्त शुद्धि द्वारा ज्ञानोत्पत्तो कारणं भवति यज्ञादि कर्म, हाउएवर इट डज नॉट मीन दैट मोक्षोत्पत्तो आल्सो इट विल बिकम अ कारण तद्वत् कर्मणां मोक्षे योग्यत्व अभावात्. इट इज नॉट योग्य फॉर कर्म टू लीड टू मोक्ष, बट चित्त शुद्धि द्वारा ज्ञानोत्पत्ति कारणमेव तत् न अपेक्षा इत्यर्थ. कर्म अपेक्षा इज नॉट देयर. सो हैविंग फिनिश्ड दिस counter to the Purva Pakshi, what is the Sakshat Sadhana? Parampara Sadhana has been mentioned. What is the Sakshat Sadhana? Bahiranga Sadhana has been mentioned. Now Antaranga Sadhana for Jnana, that is being mentioned. Jnanotpattav Bahiranga Sadhanam Abhidhaya Antaranga Sadhanam Abhidhatum Ah. Having mentioned the Bahiranga, external means to ज्ञान उत्पत्ति राइज ऑफ ब्रह्मज्ञान, व्हाट इज द अंतरंग साधना? अंतरंग साधना इज द इनर और इनर मीन्स और क्लोजर टू द राइज ऑफ उत्पत्ति, डायरेक्ट मीन्स टू ज्ञान उत्पत्ति अंतरंग साधनम. अभिधातुमाह टू मेंशन दैट भगवान सूत्रकार सेज शमदमाद्युपे तस्यात् तथापि तु तद्विधेस्तदंगतया तेषाम् अवश्यानुष्ठेयत्वात्. शमदमाद्युपे तस्यात् तथापि तु तद्विधेस्तदंगतया तेषाम् अवश्यानुष्ठेयत्वात्. सो शमदमादि उपेत, शमदमाद्युपेतः स्यात् तथा अपि तु तद्विधेहे तदंगतया तेषाम् अवश्यानुष्ठेयत्वात् इज सिंगल वर्ड देयर. सो व्हाट इज दिस शमदमादि उपेतः स्यात्. सो शमदम इत्यादि षट्क शमदम उपरति तितिक्षा श्रद्धा एंड समाधान, दीज आर द षट्क द सिक्स वैल्यूज सिक्स वर्च्यूज that the mumukshu should have to become a mumukshu really. The sadhana chatushte sampatti has viveka vairagya and then shamadamadi shatka. Fourth is mumukshutvam. So shamadamadi upeta, one who is endowed with this these six virtues syat. So upeta syat. Tathapi syat, one would be endowed with these, but तथापि तु तद्विदेहे, तथापि सो मीनिंग उपेतस्यात् ही विल बिकम एन अधिकारी, बट देर इज नो विधि सेज द पूर्वपक्षी. वेर इज द विधि फॉर दैट? देर इज नो विधि, मीनिंग what has been mentioned as vividishanti yajnena danena. Yajnena danena vividishanti. Vividishanti is latlakara. So vartamane lat, their vividishanti is not a vidhi. So shamadamadi upeta syat, says the Siddhanti. Okay, vividishanti you read as a vartamana kala latlakara, meaning just a statement, and latlakara can be in past tense also in the Shruti, or it can just mean that a statement of fact, says the Purvapakshi. That being the case, yajna dana etc. leading to vividisha is possible, but vividisha sannyasa is not a vidhi there. Then what is the antaranga sadhana? So shamadamadi, their uparati is also taken as sannyasa. Uparati is taken as sannyasa, otherwise there will be overlap with shama. So shama is antakkarana, being under one's own control. Dama is the bahir indriyas, indriyas being under one's control. So the shama and uparati also, uparati is also having some control over the sukshma sharira. So their sukshma sharira or stula sharira, stula indriyas or sukshma indriyas, all these have been mentioned, karma indriya, jnana indriyas by shamadama. So what is uparati? We have seen in Viveka Chudamani also, in the Vyakhyana also, and towards the end, having introduced these shamadamadi as sadhanas, in the beginning for a mumukshu, after jnanotpatti also shamadamadi should continue. Not only till the jnanotpatti, but after jnanotpatti also, they should continue. Even Jivan Mukti Viveka says this, that shamadamadi should continue, and uparati itself is sannyasa there. It is taken towards the end as sannyasa. The meaning of uparati is nyasa. Thereby there is no punarukti also. Does not counter or does not overlap with shama ityadi. So shama damadyupeta, and shama also, who can do shama? Naishtika brahmachari, who is naishtika in the sense that he is staying in the ashrama, not in the loka. In loka, shama is difficult. Shama, dama, both are difficult while being in the society. For grastha also it is difficult. For vanaprastha, shama, dama is possible, but he is involved in upasanas mostly. So that is also fine. But uparati means going away from all of that and focusing only in shravana. Shravana, mana, nididhyasana. Therefore, we have seen in Brahma Samstha, Amrutattva Meti, there sannyasa vidhi is there. So here shamadamadi upeta syat, one has to be endowed with shamadama ityadi. Tathapi tu, meaning tathapi means even if it is not vidhi, vividishanti is latlakara and not vidhi, tathapi tu, even then tadvidehe, tadvide is the shamadamadi itself is vidhi. Tasmad evam vichhanto danto parataha ityadi Bhrat mantra follows there as to shamadamadi is a vidhi. And since such vidhi is there, so syat is vidhiling. Syat is vidhiling here in the sutra. It is reading this vidhi from tasmad evam vichhanto danto parataha. Shanta is shama, indicating shama. Danta is indicating dama, one who is endowed with dama. So upetaha, shama upeta will be shanta, and dama upeta will be danta. Uparati upeta will be uparataha. So shanta, danta, uparataha, titikshu ityadi, all these six virtues are there in the sadhana chaturte sampatti, and they are really vidhi. Therefore tadvidehe tadangataya. Tadangataya means tad means brahma jnana, brahma vidya. So brahma vidya angataya, they will become anga to brahma vidya. What will become anga? Shamadama ityadi virtues. And thereby tesham avashya anushtiyatvat. Tesham avashya anushtiyatvat. So yajna dana etc. will lead by being external means to chitta shuddhi. And then when there is chitta shuddhi, बिकॉज यज्ञ दान इत्यादि इज वॉट कर्म योग एंड आरुक्षोर मुनेर योगम कर्म कारण उच्यते सो फार यज्ञ दान बिकम्स एक्सटर्नल मीन्स बट देन वॉट डज गीताचार्य से आफ्टर दैट योगारूढ़ तस्व शम कारण उच्यते सो योगारूढ़ तस्व तस्व कर्मिण कर्मयो योगिनः कर्मयोगिनः व्हाट इज द कारण ऑफ लेटर शम कारण उच्यते शमदम इत्यादि शम इज उपलक्षण देर सो स्मृति ऑल्सो सपोर्ट्स दैट एज इन कीपिंग विद दि विविदिशन्ति यज्ञेन दानेन फॉलोड बाय तस्माद् एवं विच्छान्तो दान्तो परतः देयर बाय तेषां अवश्य अनुष्ठेयत्वात् अवश्य अनुष्ठेयत्वात् डेफिनेटली ऑल दीज वर्च्यूज शुड बी कल्टिवेटेड एंड वन शुड मूव अवे फ्रॉम कर्म ऑल्सो एट दैट स्टेज कर्म योग ऑल्सो कर्मयोग देयर मीन्स कर्म योग ऑल्सो यद्यपि अत्र विविदिशन्ति इति वर्तमान अपदेशात् सिंस वर्तमान यूज इज देयर इन विविदिशन्ति लट लकार न विधि विधिलिंग इज नॉट देयर सो इट इज नॉट एज विधि सेज द पूर्व पक्षी तथापि इवन देन वॉट तथापि शुड बी अंडरलाइन सिंस इट्स अ सूत्र इट्स फ्रॉम सूत्र सो तथापि शमदमाद्युपेतस्तु वन शुड बी एंडोर्ड विथ शमदमा दैट अलोन इज ब्रह्म विद्यार्थी ब्रह्म विद्यार्थी स्यात् सो दैट पर्सन विल गेट ब्रह्म विद्या शमदमा लैकिंग देर कैनॉट बी ब्रह्म विद्या सो ब्रह्म विद्या विल बिकम स्थिरा इवन इफ देर इज अ ग्लिम्स इट विल बिकम स्थिरा बाय शमदम इत्यादि कुतः हाउ सो तदंगतया इट इज अंगा टू ब्रह्म विद्या शमदम इत्यादि इज अंगा विदाउट द अंगा दि प्रधाना विल नॉट बी सक्सेसफुल इन पूर्व मीमांसा ऑल्सो कर्म प्रधान कर्म इज नॉट सक्सेसफुल विदाउट अंगा अंगी इज इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट द अंगास विदाउट लिम्स वन इज इनकम्प्लीट सिमिलरली ब्रह्म विद्या बीइंग अंगी तदंगतया ब्रह्म विद्या अंगा इज वॉट विद्यांगतया ऑल दि शमतमा इत्यादि तद विधेहे सच विधि इज देर Why so? Because such vidhi, where is it there? Bhrat mantra says, sasmat evam with, one who knows in this manner, who is actually having a glimpse of moksha shastra there, as to what should be done, then shanta danta uparata. He should become a mumukshu and give up everything, have shama, have dama, and उपरति ऑल्सो बिकम उपरतः विड्रॉन फ्रॉम कर्म ऑल्सो इत्यादि तेषां शमदमादीनां विधाना सो शमदम इत्यादि विधि इज देयर तेषां विहितानां च अवश्य अनुष्ठेयत्वात् इत्यर्थः सो डेफिनेटली दिस विहित शमदम इत्यादि शुड बी प्रैक्टिस्ड फॉलोड देयर बाय दिस अधिकरण इज ओवर कर्म हैज बीन शोन एज परंपराया साधना फॉर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति बट नॉट फॉर मोक्ष एंड ब्रह्मज्ञान इट्सेल्फ विल गिव मोक्ष इंडिपेंडेंटली इट इज स्वतंत्र सो फार दिस हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड नाउ द नेक्स्ट अधिकरण इज सर्व अन्न अनुमति अधिकरण दिस इज इन यू नो इन इन द प्रसंगता इट हैज कम अप पूर्व पक्षी जस्ट वॉन्ट्स टू ब्रिंग अप समथिंग But then it can also be seen as Anga Angi Bhava is being mentioned. Then let there be Anga Angi Bhava as Prana Upasana Ityadi has been discussed earlier. So that is in the mind of the Purva Pakshi. So the Prana Upasaka can eat anything that was established. Especially we had seen in the Chakrayana Prasanga. So Chakrayana who was about to die. He is a great Upasaka and Vidwan there. Who had eaten from the Mahuta, from the one who takes care of the elephants, he had eaten his eaten food, partly eaten food. So Uchishta he had eaten, and that Uchishta is Varjita, but still he had eaten. Now this, he is a Prana Upasaka, so therefore it is allowed, and elsewhere also there is a Phala also, some Vidya Stuti was done with. This Prana Upasaka can eat anything and everything, or he has. If anyone eats anything, then this prana being the consumer of all anna, prana being annada, annamatti iti, अन्नदा, therefore this prana upasaka is also partaking of all food. This is the context in which this has come up. Now the maybe we have not seen so many details. It comes up in Chandogya, but anyway, prana upasaka has tadatmya ahangraha. He is doing ahangra upasana with prana, mukhya prana, and that mukhya prana itself is divided into multiple, and it partakes food also in each and every living being. That being so, there is ahangraha, meaning tadatmya sambandha with prana, which is partaking food in all jivas. That being so, the prana upasaka is as though consuming all sorts of food. Therefore, now Purvapakshi says, पूर्वं यथा विद्यासन्निधानात् समाधिकं विद्यांगं विधीयते इति अभिहितं तथा, जस्ट लाइक सिद्धांति हैज क्लेम्ड दैट समदमादि इज विद्यांग, ब्रह्म विद्यांग एंड विद्यासन्निधानात्, बिकॉज इट इज इन द प्रॉक्सिमिटी ऑफ विद्या, ब्रह्म विद्या, देयरफॉर इट इज अंगा टू ब्रह्म विद्या समदमादि षटकम, और द वेदर फोर आर मेंशनड, फोर ऑल्सो, and being upalakshana it can include the other two also, so all six, two have been quoted, so shama and dama or uparati, three have been quoted, it can be upalakshana for others also, and therefore the shamadikam vidyangam vidyate, vidyangam means vidyangatvena vidyate, you can see it as the kriya visheshana also, iti abhitam, in this manner as an adverb also you can see to vidyate. इति अभिहितम, दिस हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय द सिद्धांती, तथा सिमिलरली व्हाट सर्व अन्न अनुमति, अनुमति परमिशन टू ईट ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ अन्न, अभक्ष्य आल्सो, व्हाट इज अभक्ष्य टू वन कैन बी भक्ष्य टू अदर, इफ नॉट फॉर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स इट कैन बी फॉर अदर जीवास, अदर प्राणीज, सो अभक्ष्य आल्सो इफ वन ईट्स देन वन पार्टेक्स ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ अन्न, then also it is okay for a prana upasaka, especially vidyangam, so it is anga to vidya, prana vidya upasana eva vidhyate, so sarva anna anumatihi vidyangam eva vidhyate, it is vidyanga, vidyanga tvena vidhyate, it's a vidhi that one can eat anything who is a prana upasaka. This is in the mind of the Purvapakshi, and he says iti drishtant sangatya idamaha, he brings that with an anga angi bhava in the mind, and thereby sarva anna anumatyadhikaranam has come up, to which the sutrakara says sarva anna anumatischa pranatyaye tadarshanat, sarva anna anumatischa pranatyaye tadarshanat, so sarva anna anumatischa sarva anna anumatihi cha pranatyaye tadarshanat tasya darshanat shashti tatpurusha tasya darshanat, it has been seen. What has been seen? Sarva anna anumatihi cha. And it has been seen as to any anna can be taken when pranatyay. Only when there is pranatyay vipatkale ityartha. Vipatkale. It is an apad dharma. When one is unable to survive without any food, then any anna can be taken, he will not be tainted. Does not mean that anyone can take anything at any point of time. Prana upasaka also cannot eat anything and everything. It is only vidya stuti that everything that he eats will become abhakshya, also will become bhakshya. That kind of a stuti is there. It is not literal. It means that even if this person eats something, and it is not only prana upasaka, anyone can eat anything just to survive. And we see this basically happens in the loka. Nobody thinks of dharma. The mind is too weak then even to think of dharma. Very rarely is one able to say that, okay, let me give up my prana and still not take something which is avakshya. If one has a strong mind, then it is possible. But if one has not eaten for many, many, many days, then it is very difficult to, the hunger drives the person to do all sorts of adharma also. There one is allowed to eat to survive, eat anything in the limits which will be seen in the vritti, to survive, only for survival, nothing else, and it is not limited to prana upasaka, it is applicable to every living being, every human being. because dharma being for human beings, it is for every human being. And it need not be said by the Shastra also. But Shastra has given some varjana, so that it should not be done. If it is varjita, then if one is thinking that it is varjita, Shastra says that, okay, if you won't survive, then you can eat. It will not taint you. There will be no papa. That is all it is doing. It has nothing to do with vidya or karmanga, vidyanga. It has nothing to do with being upasananga at all. Purvapakshi is just bringing up with angangi bhava, but it does not belong. It does not belong at all. Such kind of a conclusion is not valid. So atra purvapakshi tadarshana pranatya tadarshana, we have seen this in the chandogya being quoted earlier in the Brahma Sutra also in the Chakrayana prasanga. So vritti says atra purvapakshi pranavidya vidho bhaksha abhaksha vibhaga asiddhi. There is no bhaksha or abhaksha vibhaga. What should be eaten, what should not be eaten. Such rules are not applicable for pranavidya upasaka. Pranavidya vit is one who is doing pranavidya upasana. One who knows the upasana and does that, for him this set of rules, these set of rules where one is to eat this, not to eat that, such kind of a thing is not there. Vidhi nisheda of relating to food is not applicable to prana upasaka, says the Purvapakshi. Siddhante tat siddhirti phalaveda. Definitely there is set of rules which is applicable for prana upasaka also, just like it is applicable for non-prana upasaka also. The bhaksha abhaksha is not going to change just because one is a prana upasaka. This is the Siddhanta. Brihadaranyake pranavidyayam shruyate. So in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, what is seen in the pranavidya? There is a stuti. Nahava asya anannam jagdham bhavati. So jagdham is bhakshitam. So whatever this asya for this prana upasaka, because in pranavidya context it has been said asya prana upasakasya. Pranavidya vidaha pranavidya upasakasya, prana upasakasya, or prana upasana upasakasya. One is doing prana upasana asya for this kind of a prana upasaka anannam jagdham anannam na ha vai bhavati. Indeed it will not become ananna, meaning whatever is eaten it will not be ananna, it will not be abhakshya iti shruyate. This is what we see in Brihad mantra. Tatra pranopasakasya kimidam sarvan anujnanam vidyangam vidyate. So is it a vidyanga? Is it vidyanga? Ask the Purvapakshi. Or is it not? Meaning when such doubt comes up as to whether pranopasakasya, all of this kimidam sarva, there is a sarva anna, it should be, there is a typo here, I missed this. So sarva anna anujnana, anumati is anujnana. So sarva anna anumati is paraphrased here by saying sarva anna anujnana. Anujnana is anumati and sarva anna is as it there should be double nakar here. Sarva anna kimidam sarva anna anujnanam vidyangam vidhiyate. Is there a vidhi for prana upasaka to eat anything and everything? Is there an anumati, permission to eat anything and everything as vidyanga? Since he is a prana upasaka, he can eat anything, and surprisingly vidyanga, as part of upasana he can eat anything. Vidyate, very odd kind of a purvapaksha. Utas tutyartham sankirtyate iti samshaye sati. So when there is a doubt as to whether as prana upasaka is allowed to eat anything, is there a anujnanam, permission, anumatihi, or is it for stuti of prana upasana as well upasaka there? Is it a praise? Vidyangam vidhiyate iti purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says it is vidyanga, prana upasaka is allowed to eat anything and it is still vidyanga. His eating itself is part of his upasana. Siddhantastu pranatye sarvam annam suravarjam yat tasya vidvamsam avidvamsam va prati adaniyatvena anumatihi anujnanam na swastam prati. So Siddhanti says that it has nothing to do with prana upasaka at all. Pranatye, when in Apatkala, when prana itself won't be there, when one won't be able to survive at all if no food is eaten, then sarvam annam, any food but anna, suravarjam, except for surapana, except for liquor. What? Except for liquor, one is allowed to eat anything just to survive, barely to retain one's prana. So suravarjam yat sarvam annam, tasya vidvamsam avidvamsam va. So for the prana vidvan upasaka or non-prana upasaka, for anyone else, not an upasaka also, for any living being, any human being, va prati, towards that person, adaniyatvena, anumati, there is a permission to eat. Adaniyatvena means to allow it, anumati is permission is to eat anything. Except for liquor, partake anything only to survive. And this is not particular to an upasaka, it is applicable to everyone. And only pranatyaya eva, na swastam prati. Only when there is a case that one won't survive without food, and what one considers as food, what one has been having as food, that is not available, then except for liquor, one can consume anything and survive. But not when one regains health or is healthy, then one should not eat abhakshya. Kutaha, why do you say so, as the Purvapakshi? Tad darshana, it is seen in the Shruti itself. Chakrayana upakhyane upastehe chakrayanasya apatkale evahitasya hastipakochishta kulmasha bhakshanasya darshanadityartha. The kulmasha, the what we say udad. So some kind of grains that the hastipaka uchishta, which is being eaten, partly eaten by hastipaka, the caretaker of the elephant, that person is eating this, and it is abhaksha. It is abhaksha because it is uchishta also, and hastipaka is not a varnatraya antargata also. So he is taking bhiksha from non-traivarnika, and on top of that he is taken uchishta. Why? Apatkaleva. Because he is almost about to die. Who is this? Chakrayana. So upasti chakrayana, in the chakrayana upakhyana, there is a narrative there as to pranavidya being discussed there. It's in the beginning itself. So in the Upasana Kanda of Chandogya, where the Udgita Upasana is also mentioned. So it begins with Udgita Upasana and moves on. So there Chakrayana is shown as very weak and about to die. So he eats Uchishta from Hasti Paka. So Apatkale Eva. Evamcha vidyabhavat, there is no such vidhi, shwadhi maryadannasya ekena attum ashakyatvacha na sarva anna anujnanam vidyangam vidyate. There is nothing called as a vidhi there at all. Just because Chakrayana is eating that, there is no vidhi that Chakrayana should eat and others who are like Chakrayana, who are prana upasaka, should eat all this. There is absolutely no such vidhi at all, and there is no vidyangatvam also. So shwadi maryada annasya. So vidya bhava, Siddhanti is saying that there is a maryada of what should be eaten, what should not be eaten. So shwa is a dog. So shwadi maryada annasya. Let me just cross check, that is not sounding right. Just me a moment. Vidya pitu sharvanitya. This is also a typo. Upaste is not ushaste. It should be ushaste. Too many typos. I don't know why I didn't check this earlier. So this should be ushaste chakrayana, not upasti. Ushaste chakrayana. So ushaste he chakrayana. Ushaste and chakrayana is samanadikaranyam. And ushaste he shashti chakrayana se also shashti. So ushaste chakrayana se apatkale eva. So padachyeda is there here. Apatasya hasti pakochishta kurmasha ityadi jay shwadi maryada maryada annasya. Yeah. मर्यादा अन्नस्य. ओके सो स्वादि मर्यादा अन्नस्य. सो देर इज अ लिमिटेशन एज टू व्हाट शुड बी ईटन व्हाट शुड नॉट बी ईटन. सो देर जस्ट बिकॉज उषस्थि चाक्रायण हैज ईटन इन आपत काल डज नॉट मीन दैट ऑल प्राण उपासकर्स हु आर स्वस्थ ऑल्सो कैन ईट एंड नॉन उपासकर्स कैन ऑल्सो ईट. इट इज नॉट ट्रू. सो इट इज योग्य वॉट एवर इज सी स्वादि मर्यादा अन्नस्य एकेन अत्तु एकेन एकेन मनुष्येण इट शुड बी सीन एज एकेन मनुष्येण मनुष्य मात्रेण. सो वॉट एवर अ डॉग ईट्स दैट कैन नॉट बी ईटन बाय अ मनुष्य. सो एवं च विद्यभा स्वादि मर्यादान्नस्य एकेन अत्तुम अशक्यत्वात्. सो वॉट एवर वन कैन ईट वन शुड ईट बट देन सुरा सुरावर्जित बिकॉज देर इज अ निषेध देर. सो वॉट एवर इज निषिद्ध ऑल्सो कैन बी अभक्ष्य इट विल बिकम अभक्ष्य एंड इट कैन ऑल्सो बी ईटन इन आपत काल बट नॉट सुरपान. सो एकेन अत्तुम अशक्यत्वाच्च न सर्वान्न अनुज्ञानं विद्यांगं विद्यते. डेफिनेटली देर इज नो विधि एज विद्यांग टू ईट एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग फॉर अ प्राण उपासक एंड नॉन उपासक ऑल्सो. देर इज वर्जित इन स्वस्थावस्था अपितु प्राणमात्रस्य अन्नमिदं सर्वमिति यच्चिन्तनं विहितं. सो प्राणमात्रस्य अन्नमिदं सर्वम ऑल दिस अन्न ईटन बाय ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ beings that is seen in the samvarga vidya also. In samvarga vidya brahmachari goes and asks for bhiksha. So there are two grahasthas who look at him and then they say that let's tease him or let's teach him a lesson, because it is well known that that brahmachari is a prana upasaka and he thinks that he knows everything. There is garva. So for that reason also it can be seen. There are multiple interpretations to that mantra there or that khanda there. So this in samvarga vidya is brahmachari who is asking for bhiksha. Initially they say they deny, they don't give. So when they don't give, this prana upasaka gets angry or he just with garva of prana upasana, he has tadatmya bhava with prana, he is doing ahangra upasana. So he tells them that you do not know that you are denying food to one for whom you have cooked. Whosoever you have cooked for, that is the entity who is asking for bhiksha, and you are denying to that prana because he has tadatmya sambandha ahangra bhava with prana, and he says all of the cooking is for prana. So anyone who is eating or anyone is cooking anything is for prana, and that prana I am. He does not say that, but in so many words, but he means that. He says that to that very brahmachari you are denying food. So to whosoever you are cooked, you do not know that you are denying bhiksha food to that entity itself. And then they say that we know, or we do upasana of prana, or we do not do upasana of that limited prana. Both interpretations are there. So they say that we know more than this prana who is Brahma, or prana as Brahma. So we do prana upasana as Brahma, or we don't do prana upasana as a limited prana, but we do upasana of someone more than that entity who is sarvam. So this is how they answer. Both interpretations are there, and then they say give bhiksha. So it is not that they don't give bhiksha, they give bhiksha to him later, but just to see as to how much he knows what is his garva all about. So in that context, in samvarga vidya this comes up. So he is that prana, and therefore apitu prana matrasya annam idam sarvam, all this anna is seen in samvarga vidya as anna to for prana, and brahmachari has ahangraha tadatmya with that prana in his upasana. Therefore prana matrasya annam idam, it is not for anyone else, it is only for prana that all food is there. So whether it is bhaksha or abhaksha, it is for prana, and since prana upasaka has tadatmya, it is for me. Therefore I, the prana upasaka, is allowed to eat anything. I am allowed to eat anything. This can be the thinking iti yachintanam vihitam. So that thinking which comes up by this vidhi, tat stutyartham sankirtyate iti bhava. So it is only for the vidya stuti. Why the upasaka who can consume anything, thereby it becomes vidya stuti. It is not literal, says the Siddhanti. Further, why so? Abhadacha. Because of badha not being appropriate. There is no badha of Nisheda Shruti. So, we'll see the detail in the single line, two line vritti there. Bhaksha Bhaksha Viveka Shastrasya Abhadacha. There is no badha, there is no negation which is appropriate. You should not, there is no badha by Upanishad of the Karmakanda Vidhi. Bhaksha and Abhaksha, Vidhi and Nishera Shastra is for what can be eaten, what cannot be eaten. That cannot be superseded by an Upanishad Vakya literally. With, at the same level of satta, you cannot negate the Vidhi and Nishera Shastra. By Paramartha, by Paramarthika perspective, everything is Badita. But you cannot have a partial Badha. So, Bhaksha Bhaksha Viveka Shastra is there. Karmakanda says what should be eaten, what should not be eaten. What is Bhaksha, what is Abhaksha? So, there is no Badha there. Abhadacha. Arthavada Matram Ityartha. This statement of prana upasaka being prana matra, all anna sarva is his own anna, that kind of a statement is anuvada matram. It is arthavada matram, not anuvada, arthavada matram. It is just vidya stuti. Otherwise what will happen? Anyatha samanya shastram vishesha parataya niyamanam baditam syaditi bhava. Otherwise what will happen? In some context something has been said in arthavada, you take it literally, and then Samanya Shastra, Karmakanda, all over is there, which is giving Vidhi and Pratisheda. Vishesha Parataya, that which is committed to a particular thing, Niyamanam, if you take it through the interpretation which is in a particular context, if you take it and apply it to any other place and take it literal, then Samanya Shastram Baditam Syat. It will become badita and that is inappropriate. Iti bhava. Api chasmaryate. And there is smriti also. So if shruti has not been seen properly by us, if it is the aropa, akshepa, if samshaya is there, then it will be clarified by quoting smriti also, says the Siddhanti Sutrakara. Apicha apatkale vidushah avidushascha sarva anna bhakshanam smaryate. There is a smriti which says that sarva anna bhakshanam, any food can be eaten by the vidwan or avidwan, whether it is a upasaka or a non-upasaka, whether a jnani or an ajnani, when apatkale. So apicha, and even the smriti confirms this understanding that we have got from the shruti as valid. Jivitatyam apanno yuannam atti yatastataha lipyatena sapapena padmapatram ivambhasa iti. So this smriti says that jivita atyam apannaha, one who is about to lose his life, about to die, yaha, one who annam atti yatastata, however he sources and eats whatever kind of food, atti annam atti, sa papena na lipyate, he is not tainted by papa of that abhaksha anna. How? Padma patram ivambhasa. This is well known. So padma patra, like the lotus leaf, is not wetted by the droplets of water that it carries, but it is untouched. It remains dry. It can just shake it off. So this apatkala vidusha or vidwan or avidwan also, who has eaten abhaksha just to survive, once he gains the swastya, meaning not gains swastya also, when he is surviving, then he can follow the rules, dharma shastra, and stick to bhaksha, not consume any abhaksha, and whatever abhaksha is partaken, that will not taint him. Iti madhyam nityam brahmano varjet iti cha. And madhyam, this surapana, liquor, brahmana nityam varjet. One should not drink liquor at all. Now why only brahmana? Why not kshatriya, vaishya, ityadi? So kutrachid yuddha prasange kshatriyasya madhyapanam kathyate. Somewhere, you know, in yuddha prasanga, kshatriya is mentioned as consuming madhya. Therefore, Brahmana has been mentioned here. Because Kshatriya has to fight a yuddha, even soldiers here, if you see, soldiers are, I've heard that soldiers are, quite a few soldiers who have been brought up culturally, they cannot go and fight a war, battle or a war. You cannot, you have to be unkind towards the enemy soldier. You can't be unkind if you are following dharma values. Very difficult. It is easy to say, you know, Jai Hind and all that, but on the, we can only imagine what a soldier feels, especially, you know, one who has been brought up culturally with ahimsa ityadi is unable to kill a mosquito also. Imagine that person has to kill an enemy. So even a kshatriya, although such kind of a bravery, courage, all that is there, but still even with that, even if one is consuming non-vegetarian food also, it is difficult to attack and kill a human being. It is very difficult. You can see from that person's perspective, from a soldier's perspective. So there, I've heard that, many of these people drink and then fight. So such kind of a thing is there in the scene in Purana Ityadi also. Therefore, Madhyam Nityam Brahmano Varjayet Iti. Smritim Moola Bhutam Shrutim Apyaha. Now, not Apichas Mariyate, Smriti is there. But there is Shruti also for this, says the Sutrakara. Smriti Moola Bhutam Shrutim Apyaha. There is a Shruti on which this Smriti has dependency, and thereby Shabdashchato Kamakare. So Shabdashch, Shabda means Shruti is also there. Ataha Pranavidaha. For this Pranavit Akamakare. Meaning, Kamakara is, one who is doing as per one's own Ichcha. But Swechha Pravritti Nirase, that is the meaning of Akamakare. Not driven by Kama, consuming anything and everything based on one's own desire, that is not the case. So there is a Shabda like this. As to what, we'll see in the Vritti. So the padachida shabdaha cha ataha akamakare. So asya abhakshyam bhakshanasya pratishedaha asya akamakare. Towards the akamakara, based on one's own ichha, one should not consume anything and everything. Otherwise, liquor also one may consume, which is a mahapataka. In one of the pancha mahapatakas, therefore, Shruti says that. What is that? Asya abhakshya bhakshanasya pratisheda. Otherwise, Shruti wouldn't do pratisheda. How does it do pratisheda? Tasmad brahmana suram napibet. So here, the madhyam nityam brahmano varjayet is a smriti, to which the moola shruti is tasmad brahmana suram napibet. One should not, tasmad, whatever is has gone by earlier, brahmana should not consume liquor. Iti evam rupa shabdascha akamakare. Akamakare, this kind of a shabda is pramana there, akamakare, towards akamakara. What is that akamakara? Swechha kruta pravritti nirase shruyate. To withdraw oneself from swechha kruta karma such as drinking surapana. To do surapana, there may be swechha. One's own ichcha may be there, okay, let me have liquor. Everyone is partying out, let me also, especially today, 31st December, year end, let me go to parties, and everyone drinks today, why not? So that Swechha Kruta Pravritti, one may have Pravritti, one may engage in such kind of a thing also. So Nirasa, one is pulled out of that by this Pratisheda Vakya in Shruti. Ataha Pranavidaha Sarvanna Anujnanam Arthavada Matram Iti Siddham. Ataha is not Pranavidha. Ataha can be seen that, but Ataha can be Ataha Asmat Karanat. So because of that, Pranavidaha, for a Pranavit, for a Prana Upasaka, Sarvanna Anujnanam Anumati, to eat anything and everything, that is Arthavada Matram Iti Siddham. It is not Vidyanga, let alone for Prana Upasaka. It is not applicable only to Prana Upasaka, but it is applicable to everyone in Apatkala alone, and not even for Prana Upasaka इफ इज हेल्दी लेट अलोन अदर्स. सो अर्थवाद मात्रम इति सिद्धम, इट इज ओनली एन अर्थवाद. देयर बाय दिस अधिकरण इज ऑल्सो ओवर. वी लुक एट आश्रम कर्माधिकरण इन दि नेक्स्ट पाठ. आश्रम कर्माधिकरण इन दि नेक्स्ट पाठ. हैविंग टेकन अ डिटूर हियर दि थ्रेड कंटिन्यूज वेयर बाय दिस विविदिशा. फॉर विविदिशा वॉट इज दि कारण फॉर ज्ञान उत्पत्ति इत्यादि दैट काइंड ऑफ अ कॉन्टेक्स्ट दि पूर्व पक्षी इज रिटर्निंग टू. एंड देयर बाय आश्रम कर्म दैट वी हैव सीन ही विल ब्रिंग अप another objection and try to take back and hijack the interpretation which has been done by the Siddhanti, and the counter he is going to try to reverse. We'll see that in the next part. Amna yantika samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam ananda ghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupas mahe. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.